Hi there, Aries. Aries sun, moon, and rising sign. This is your January 2021 Love Monthly Forecast reading with me, Chrissy, from In the Stars by Chrissy.com. Now, it's finally a new year ahead, and I just want to greet you guys a happy, happy, happy new year this year of 2021. If you haven't seen my video on the yearly energy forecast, I did upload that last few weeks, I don't know. I'll just put the link at the upper right or left corner of the screen. Please do check it out if you're interested to see, you know, a worldwide kind of predictions and energy forecast reading. But anyway, on to January this month, I did a two decks to give in a little bit more detailed and emphasis to what might be transpiring for each and one every one of us, as I believe that, you know, every January puts a theme to what might be coming up for the entire year. So yeah, that's that. If you are interested to find out what are, you know, what this is really all about, please do stay tuned and listen through this until the end of the video. Please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe, and don't forget to tick the bell icon to get notified whenever I post videos just like this one, as your help and support to the channel is always appreciated. So without further ado, let's just dive into this. So the first card that we have over here is the Temperance and the Star card. And this is actually a very, very wonderful energy if you would ask me. I started with this card over here. And this is really more about having a sense of peace and, you know, having that energy of wanting to dream what I really wanted to do in life. You are in that kind of vibe, and being an Aries yourself, I kind of feel that a lot of you are wanting to have some form of change, or you wanted to begin something, or you have a lot of visions in your life right now. It is being crossed over by the King of Pentacles along with the Five of Pentacles all the same time. So some of you might be thinking of starting a new business or trying to do some form of initiation to what kind of business that you wanted to create, or, you know, wanting to have some form of security, financial stability in life. When it comes to love, this could be a situation wherein you might be, you know, being over the moon thinking about a specific person in your life, or, you know, yeah, because you do have here the Queen of Swords and the Emperor card as the I would say the issue, the core issue or foundation. You could be in a situation right now wherein something is not entirely in a balanced state. You could be, you know, this is about you desiring to conquer something, desiring to conquer either a person or desiring to conquer a specific situation in your life. May it be for business situation, or it could be with a partnership with someone, a relationship with someone. This is something that you are wanting to have, wanting to conquer, and wanting to initiate all at the same time. These are all the things that are coming up in your head. You know, you are being filled with your dreams and goals in life. You know, you are, you know, you are at the point wherein there's a lot of things backing up in you, and you have the energy to pursue things that, you know, you wanted to accomplish. This could be, you know, for some of you, this could just be a sigh of relief that finally 2020 is finally over. I can start over something new this year. You know, it could be just thoughts about like that. Now, in your immediate past, you know, since we're taking a look on the love life sector of your life, I just really want to emphasize on this as well. In your recent past, you have here the Moon card along with the King of Swords. So this could be a situation wherein you might be thinking about something, you know, a specific person in your life. there could be a factor of very emotional or melancholic kind of energy that might be transpiring in that. It could be with a situation or a person that is not very, maybe they are not answering you, or they're not reciprocating whatever it is that you're feeling. There could be a lack of communication even. And this is something that you wanted to close a gap on, I feel. And over here, we do have here the Four of Pentacles along with the Page of Wands. And like I said, this is something that, you know, maybe it is something that you have been holding on to. This is something that you really, really want to get in touch with. You know, you might be in a situation where and you really want to get in touch with someone. And it could be someone that you have lost touch with, or it could be someone that you haven't talked to for quite a while, but has a special place in your heart. So there are issues like that over here. So this could also be a situation wherein, you know, there is some form of dream and desire that you have inside of you in your heart that you wanted to accomplish, that you wanted to manifest into reality. And, you know, regardless of whatever setbacks that you might have encountered, this is something that you really just cannot let go of just because of whatever circumstances that are happening in your life. When we see the Four of Pentacles with the situation of your own crowning thoughts, this is something that you wanted to grab hold of. You really cannot let go. You don't want to let go, you know? It's like having, for some people, this could be a very selfish energy, you know? This could be a very selfish demeanor, I would say. But all at the same time, this is about you really becoming more passionate of what you desire, what you want. And it's like, for some people, this could be a situation that, you know, you really, really hold dear and you want to fight for it. You want to have the strength to overcome adversities because you care about whatever situation is it, you know? Like, again, this could be a business, something that can bring you stability in life. This could also be a situation wherein that pushes you in an emotional scale to tell yourself that, you know, I am alive by doing this. You know, what I'm doing right now, the things that I want to fight for, makes me feel complete, makes me feel alive. So those things are going to be a big factor for you. So if you are in a situation wherein you are confused, you could be in a, you might be coming into a situation wherein you want to do something to remove that confusion. You know, the things that you have been very, very much passive about, things that you have been thinking, things that you have been dreaming, these are the things that you wanted to take action on. And you might very well, you know, take initiative action this month all at the same time. You know, you just cannot help it. This is something that you desire, that you want as a whole. And if you are going to repress this, I kind of feel that everything is going to be turning going to be very internalized. And I kind of feel that for some of you, you are going to repress this. You know, maybe you have your own belief system about what you should do, what you should not do. And, you know, because we do have here the Emperor card, and the Emperor card, you know, Emperor card is not a bad card, okay? It is, you know, it is a leader, very authoritarian, and it usually governs in making decisions, whether you should initiate on something or not. It's also a very good business card if you are interested with that. However, one factor about the Emperor card is that it tends to hesitate a lot. Like, I want letter A, I want letter B. There's a lot of things that I want to do, but I was not really able to do it. So there's a lot of hesitations when it comes to the Emperor card. And, you know, it is a factor that makes a person unable to really take action. Yes, I desire something, I desire a person. I want to take action, to communicate with them, to talk to them, to work something out. But because of that hesitation, or maybe because you have your own ego that I should be in power, I need to do what I have told myself to do and see it through the end, you know, you might be having that kind of energy, you know. And just before I continue with the reading, let me just clarify that this could be, you know, something that's happening to you, or this could be a situation that is relating to the person that you are connected with all at the same time. So it's happening, it can happen in a vice versa kind of manner, so just keep that in mind. Now we have here the Nine of Swords coming up into your immediate future. The Nine of Swords and the Four of Cups will make you somehow very emotional, especially if you are going to decide to repress things, trying to repress your own feelings, trying to not do anything to maybe to maintain the status quo of a situation. You might be going to be suffering from, you know, some emotional situation. There could be a lot of fear that might creep up on you, or a lot of anxiety and worry that might come up. And I'm talking about this in a way wherein this might be going to be a situation if you are going to repress yourself, because this is a time for you to take action. This is a time for you to initiate, to really do something. And if you don't do something, I kind of feel that this energy that, you know, is lingering around you and with your relationships is going to, you know, to hit you quite hard, or might just upset you. It's like astrology in a way, you know. When something is about to happen and manifest in astrology, it's not really the fault of astrology. Astrology just manifests things, you know, the transits and all of that. This is the energy that comes into manifestation. And whether you use that energy to take for your advantage or not is a different matter. So I just kind of feel that, you know, these are the lingering energies that are unfolding for you at this time. And and if you don't, you know, make use of this energy, I kind of feel that it might lead you to some form of disappointment, or you might be having some form of frustration for a sudden news that might come up, or a lack of news that might happen. This could be also a situation wherein you are missing someone or missing something in your relationship. You are desiring for something, really a lot of hopes and dreams and stuff like that, and you might be disappointed with what reality is showing you versus what you envision your life and your love life to be. So there could be frustration in that, or at the very least, this could be the breaking point for you to take action, because of the desire and disappointment will force you to initiate something, or to initiate some form of conversation, communication with a specific person in your life, you know. So over here, we are seeing another hesitating card, which is the Two of Pentacles, trying to balance things out, trying to make do of whatever that you can. You could be in that situation. I kind of feel that for a lot of you guys, there is really one special person in your life that you are really thinking about, and there's really big hesitation on how to deal with it, basically. It's what we are seeing. At the very least, this could be happening in a form of fear, but all at the same time, you know, I kind of feel that this could be a situation that you really, really need to make a decision of whether you're ready for it or not. I kind of feel that you are going to take action for it, because you're an Aries. Aries initiate and Aries acts, you know? So it's not really you to hesitate on something. So this is really a point wherein if you feel like doing it, you are gonna do it eventually. So it has that form of energy. Just keep that in mind. Over here, we do have the Five of Swords and the Three of Cups. So this is really a point wherein you know that you wanted to connect with someone that maybe in the past, or maybe you had some falling out with this relationship. Maybe you wanted to mend this relationship up. You want to have some form of harmony. You want to have some form of security in that relationship. And these are the factors that are showing up. So basically, maybe you had something did not really work out in that relationship, and you want to work something out with it. So this is basically your desire showing up and giving us the information that it could be a relationship that had some quite of a history in the past, and this is something that you are really hoping to resolve. Over here, we do have the Ten of Swords. So this is really showing up a lot of your fears that maybe it's not gonna work out. Maybe there's going to be a lot of hurt in the process, or maybe you are going to be rejected and turned down and all of those kinds of stuff. This could be, a lingering disappointment of someone that someone has given you, or maybe you have given someone. Especially when we have here the Moon and the Ten of Swords, we already know that, you could be dealing with a situation or a relationship that somehow, I would not say toxic, but it could be a situation wherein there has been some great disappointments. We also have here the King of Swords and the Queen of Cups. So this is a situation wherein, maybe two couples, the couple has had a fight over something, and there was a lot of emotional backlash and stuff like that. So it's really hard to try to fix this kind of relationship, but all at the same time, the desire of wanting to fix a relationship is all there. So yeah, and over here, overall, this is the Death card along with the Two of Cups. Now I see this really more of trying to reborn a relationship or transform a relationship, or accepting the fact that things have ended, but you can actually start anew. This is a situation wherein wanting to start anew into the relationship, trying to put on a reset button into a certain scenario, because I really do not see this as the end cycle of a relationship, because we do have a I did pick out a few more cards over here. So let me just open them. I did pull quite a few Lenormand cards, like I usually do every time I do readings like this, whether I show it in on camera or not. So I did pick clarification cards for this reading to give me more detail into the scenario, whether this is an ending card or a reset button card of a situation. And here we have the Clouds and the Male card. This could be the person that you are in concern with, or it could be you if you're an Aries man. This could be your confusion of whether you should communicate and try to connect with the relationship, bring up the love back again into a situation. Over here, this is about you wanting to communicate, surprise that person, maybe trying to initiate something with that person. And over here, it really takes a lot of, work, basically, because when we see the crossroads over there, you are at the verge of making a major decision, a major communication of sort. So, and it might involve with an older lover or, an old flame maybe. So, and we do have the Birds card over here. This could be a situation wherein, this could be a form of there is a confusion in the relationship or a situation that might lead to some form of struggles in a form of communication. That is one aspect. that this can happen. And all at the same time, this could be also a situation wherein you are confused on whether you should communicate and talk to a person, and then, you know, making a major decision to try to work things out, try to mending a relationship, because, you know, overall, the bird's card is always about communication, exchanges, and stuff like that, trying to talk things out, you know, trying to get information over something, basically. So yeah, so we are getting the backup of communication being a major factor into this reading all at the same time. So there could be a return of something, a return of love into your relationship. There's going to be more communication, I feel. There's going to be growth and development in terms of talking and communicating with someone, especially if things have not been very well for you and your partner or potential person in your life. So this is about you wanting to have some form of emotional fulfillment and to commit, you know, to be in a relationship, to commit with someone, all those kinds of things, and some form of happiness in the air. All those things are coming up. So this is about you wanting to restore something that was unbalanced but is very, very much important to you, something that is very crucial to your heart all at the same time. So yeah, it's I feel that this is about you, you know, having the courage to initiate something and having the courage and willingness to reset something in your love life and relationship sector of your life. You know, you might have been hesitant about it, you might have been really, really afraid to take this action, but your heart is going to be speaking to you this month, and your heart is basically going to show you the way whether you should go for it or not, or whether you should completely forget about it. So we are seeing two aspects of scenario here, wherein this might be turning to a point wherein things might end. And for some people, this could be a situation wherein I want to reset this type of relationship. I really love this relationship, and this is the relationship that I've always dreamed of, always envisioned with, and I really want to treasure it for my entire life. Maybe I wanted to marry this person. I wanted to have a special connection with this person once again, and I want to rebuild the relationship and make it last this time around. So there, you know, we are receiving this type of energy. So I really am seeing this in a very positive light, though, you know, since this is a general reading, I can also see this happening in a negative situation for other people. So you will have to take a look into your own situation and use your own intuition on how best you can navigate it and how best this is really going to be unfolding for each and every one of you. So yeah, thank you guys for watching and tuning in with me. I do hope that I was able to give you the insight and clarity that you might need into your situation. I do hope that somehow, one way or another, you find this insightful all at the same time. So yeah, thank you guys, and I'll see you guys next month. Goodbye.